Well, just having a light moment with our celebrity anchor tonight, who is none other than Humphrey Nabimanya, the team lead and director of Richer Hand Uganda. You're welcome, Humphrey.
Thank you so much.
Have you anchored before?
Actually, this is my first time.
But you've been before cameras?
Yeah, I've been before cameras and so many times, actually. So, I'm quite
so there's nothing like nervousness. You're like...
No, I'm just excited, but just being nervous, being in a different
kind of
angle.
Setting.
Yeah, kind of setting is quite different. So formal, not as usual. You know how we do our things. But senior man.
I get it. The team but anyway, yes. Aside of that, just a brief before we could go to the next story.
Yeah.
Who is Humphrey Nabimanya?
Humphrey Nabimanya is the team lead and founder of Richer Hand Uganda. Mm-hmm. It's a youth organization that is looking at different issues of our young generation today. Issues on
youth
livelihood programs. We have health programs that we deal with sexual reproductive health challenges that face young people and trying to find new solutions for them, addressing issues on teenage pregnancy, child marriage issues in the northern region.
It's mainly about the youth.
It's mainly about the youth, but we look at different sectors, and also we try to incorporate all these sectors all together so that we can have one solution to solve them.
Okay.
Yeah.
So from the little I know, your background is from Ruampara, which I also happen to come from. But anyway,
yeah,
we'll
shall
start
talk
on
about
that later.
Yeah.
So you will start off with our story for.
Yeah, our story this week. This week, the Land Probe Committee interviewed witnesses from Kapeka in Nakaseke District. The suspected land grabbers was pinned for subjecting the witness to torture in illegal detention on claims that are trespassing on his land. Swaibiga prompts to be the landlord of six villages. He's accused of grabbing over 1,000 acres of land in Butaritira, Manywa, Senda, Naruvule, Mizimbo in Sinju village.
15-year-old Stephen Mukumbia is battling complications in his private parts, which he reportedly sustained as a result of torture by a suspected land grabber, Swaibuiga. Mukumbia, who lives with his aunt, Teddy Najuma, in Mizimbo village, Kapeka sub-county in Nakaseke district, met his fate after a one Haji Swaibuiga pounced on him over claims that Mukumbia stole his maize and farm tools. Another torture victim is Sekalango Godfrey, a resident of Balatira, who nearly met his death about a week ago on Iga's orders. He's currently on remand on charges he doesn't even know.
He first undressed me and tore all my shirts or buttons.
And na, then,
Na
driver we nanyigirizo mutwe yena kwata magaru nanyiga.
His driver pressed my head, then had got pliers and squeezed my genitals. We were never stopped. All we had were bullets being fired. My colleague jumped off. I don't know where, which direction it took. I continued. I sped off until I failed to control the motorcycle.
The duo is among the thousands of residents who lost their land to suspected land grabber Haji Swaibuiga. While Iga claims he is the landlord, the family of the late Yakobo Lukwago, the initial landlords, told the Commission of Inquiry into Land Matters that they hired Iga to survey their land. They, however, cannot tell how he took over the land that measures to over 1,180 acres.
When he transferred my title from its plot to another plot.
Which one was that?
Which road?
The chapa changi chari kupoloti chikumi nkaga mmu naana na chichusa na achiza kuiviri muemu.
My title was on plot 168 and he transferred it to 201.
The would-be owner of the land is also crying foul over Iga's tactics of grabbing the 2 square miles estate of the late Yakobo Lukwago. Their only request is that the commission avails them a resurvey of the land with hope of recovering hundreds of acres lost to the alleged land grabber.
Report.
Yiga, who's also being investigated by the Land Commission and Lands Minister Betty Amongi, is not the sole beneficiary of his sinister actions. Other beneficiaries include the officer in charge of Kapeka Police Station, Christine Otai. Information available to the commission shows that Otai illegally got 10 acres from the contested land. The commission ordered for her arrest and she is to be investigated by the Police Professional Standards Unit. The Commission of Inquiry yesterday accused Nakaseke District Administrator General for not doing enough to secure the estate. The Deputy Administrator General of Nakaseke, Jacqueline Mazinga, who appeared before the commission, could not avail any lasting solution to the problem, but instead appealed to the commission to do the job she would have done.
The steps to have been taken at that time were, of course, lodging caveats on his respective interests. The fact that we had discovered that he had not made good of what he had told the beneficiaries.
Interestingly, the pivotal person in the whole saga, Haji Swaibuiga, snubbed the commission's summons. He instead sent his lawyer, Awan Gaston Kamugisha, who was also arrested by the commission for trying to undermine its activities as well as mislead the witnesses he was addressing in the hearing hall.
One Mr. Kamugisha Gaston stood up and began to address members of the public and press who were seated in the public hearing hall. Mr. Kamugisha's comments, as reported, were made in a loud and offensive manner and appeared to be calculated to undermine the authority and conduct of the commission.
Swaibuiga Mkasa, who purports to be a landlord of 6 villages in Kapeka sub-county, is accused of grabbing over 1,000 acres of land and torturing the people he found on the land. The disputed land covers Balatira, Manua, Senda, Naluvule, Mizimbo and Nzingu villages. Yiga is currently being investigated by the Justice Catherine Bamgemerire Land Commission and Lands Minister Betty Amongi on how he acquired the land. Report filed by Rachel Nachwala for Urban TV.
Away from the land probe, you can get to rate our celebrity anchor Humphrey Nwamanya today on PM Live by giving us on a scale of 1 to 10. What do you think he has done best, or maybe his worst moments? Now, moving on, 10 suspects, including a deputy DSO and LC3 chairperson, have been sent to prison over theft of drugs from different government health units in Liwa, Apache, and Amulata districts. The suspects were arrested by detectives from State House Health Monitoring Unit, led by Karugaba Collins, DSP, in an operation that kicked off on Wednesday.
37-year-old Agnes Amugu and 30-year-old James Lango are jointly charged with unlawful possession of government stores contrary to Section 316 of the Penal Code Act. 54-year-old Baluku Henry, the Deputy District Internal Security Officer, or DISO, of Lira District, 37-year-old James Okelo and 48-year-old Bernard Adoko, also LC3 chairperson of Amach sub-county in Lira District, are jointly charged with 2 counts of compounding felony contrary to Section 504 of the Penal Code Act and neglecting to prevent a felony contrary to Section 389 of the Penal Code Act. Hey. 29-year-old Gloria Muge is charged with unlawful possession of government stores. 28-year-old Eric Okulu is charged with 2 counts of unlawful possession of government stores and sale of impure drugs contrary to Section 30 of the National Drug Policy and Authority Act. Sixty-eight-year-old Etoku Julius is charged with 2 counts of unlawful possession of government stores and receiving stolen property. Other suspects include 33-year-old Ojuka Moses and 38-year-old Onedo Ben, jointly charged with theft, contrary to Section 254, subsection 1, and Section 261 of the Penal Code Act, and unlawful possession of government stores. The suspects were first held at Lira Central Police Station before being taken to court, where they were remanded to Lira Central Prison.
In Amaratar, that's my hospital, we recovered drugs, which is approximately 18 billion shillings, as per the charges statement and evaluation. This one overdue, it's about 12 million shillings. at Okere Center for. Then this one, which was with the LCC chairman at 5 million. Then plus these others from several, about 9 drug shops. Its operations are to monitor the medical delivery services, the health delivery services. So we usually carry out monitoring exercises.
The magistrate, Peter Odo, said the case is triable by the chief magistrate and the suspects will appear before him on Monday to take plea. This report was filed by Hudson Apunyo for Urban TV.
Chadondo East Member of Parliament Robert Kyagulanyi, commonly known as Bobi Wine, has asked street children to abandon drug abuse for hard work to become successful in life. Bobi Wine was in Gulu District for a concert that ended up last evening at Smiling Panda. The artist turned politician met over 90 street children today, empowering them using his life story as a ghetto boy turned into then an MP. He strongly urged the street kids to stop drug abuse, to work hard and in successful for successful life.
Excellency Bobi Wine, now Member of Parliament, empowering the youth and the street children. Now, renowned R&B artist Eddie Kenzo has scooped 3 awards at the Uganda Music Awards. Bruno K, on the other hand, couldn't control the tears of joy after scooping the Best Reggae Award of the Year. Compared to the different awards held in Uganda, the turn-up for the Uganda Music Awards was massive.
Artists and revelers were thrilled by the first edition of the Uganda Music Awards held last night at the Kampala Serena Hotel. The newly created awards could restore the pride and trust Ugandans had in award events.
This is the award for Video of the Year, directed by Josh the Fixer. Keys played by Paul Mayanja. Like, so many people have been, like, clay dancers are in the video, man. There was a bed, like, flower. It's crazy. You need to see it, yeah.
I think winning is a choice. You just need to work really hard. Everyone can be a winner. We're born winners.
The Ghana Music Awards intend to recognize and celebrate outstanding artistic achievements, technical proficiency, performance excellence, and positive contribution to the music industry of Uganda. Moritz scooped the Best Breakthrough Artist Award. Brian Luega walked away with the Best Gospel Artist Award. MC Wang Jok scooped the Best Artist Northern Region. Destiny scooped Best Artist Eastern Region. Cesara scooped Best Artist Central Region. Kigambo Arali scooped Best Artist Western Region. Nina Rose scooped the Fans Choice Award. Matthias Walukagat scooped the Best Kadongo Kamu Award. Bruno K scooped the Best Reggae Artist Award. Rubber Dabba was voted Best Ragga Dance Hall Artist. B2C scooped the Best Dance Troupe Award. Eddie Kenzo scooped the award for Best Urban Artist. Angela Katatumba scooped the Humanitarian Award. Fie scooped the Best Afro Pop Award. Rose Mboa scooped the Lifetime Achievement Award. Eddie Kenzo scooped the Song of the Year Award. The Female Artist of the Year Award went to Irene Tale. And the Best Male Artist of the Year was won by Eddie Kenzo, who also won the overall award for the Artist of the Year.
Being an award-winning artist, I think you should be favored by God and from the people that believe in you, because many artists come but the chosen a few, you know that. Yeah.
To Eddie Kenzo, indeed, he must have gone home a happy man. Now, PM Live takes another short break, but we return with many more stories, including... We get up close and personal with Humphrey Narimanya, our celebrity anchor today.